Okay, today I want to lend my voice to a cause that will likely continue to grow in the near term while hopefully getting sorted in the long term. The issue is complex and not fully understood as of yet, I think, but appears to be a horrifically malicious new growth tactic on YouTube that is costing thousands of people their account access and even compromising private video content that should not otherwise be accessible. Before going further, I want to make a few things very clear. One, the majority of background footage comes from a creator named Evans1111, who is the original source to investigate this topic. In the time since, The Quartering has picked it up, I believe Keemstar has mentioned it as well, and countless other channels are probably producing or have already produced coverage of their own. The end goal is to get YouTube to respond effectively and hastily to a problem that, if true, is one of the worst to ever exist on the entire platform. The basic rundown is as follows. Somewhat recently, bot programs began to infiltrate the comment sections of various YouTube videos. This is a prolific issue on the platform and has seen a steady rise in recent weeks since it first became known. On a surface level, the format seems kind of innocuous, but if you delve deeper, as Evans did in his own segment, I will have a link to his channel below to subscribe. However, stick around because there are a few additional notes on that to add later for safety reasons, but yeah, I'll get to that in a minute. But anyways, if you delve deeper, it appears these bot comments are designed to drive traffic to a particular channel. I've seen a number of them crop up with different taglines. Some say, wow, great content, 5 seconds after the video goes up, and they're also saying this on pretty much every video that gets uploaded to the entire platform. Others say, hey, great work, or even, wanna be friends? The name that comes to mind for me that I've personally seen is Tim, or Tem, a bot that would appear on my own videos as well with a simple automated comment within seconds of uploading, but for today's focus, we will be looking at a bot that goes by the name of Logan. Logan is an actual channel, a channel that is growing fairly rapidly now, and there is much more to this angle, such as name changes and previous upload history, which Evans did an excellent job of outlining in his own segment, but the core of the issue is that Logan has somehow devised a bot program that can crawl YouTube and fire off comments on a massive number of fresh uploads, so much so, in fact, if you sort basically any YouTube keyword, search by most recent, a comment might exist from him saying, "Wanna be friends?" This, in a vacuum, might seem like just an annoying bot, really no big deal, but here is where things take a sinister turn. If you go to Logan's actual channel, his videos are overrun with what appear to be false engagement, or at least they were, but I'll get to that in a minute. What do I mean by false engagement? Well, an organic YouTube comment section usually contains actual comments, not one-word spam such as nice or hi in ridiculously large quantities. Furthermore, if you investigate these channels, the ones simply posting nice on all of Logan's videos, as Evans discovered, they belong to legitimate users, many of whom have past uploads, varying numbers of subscribers, and by all definitions, they are actual people, operating as a bot would to inflate the engagement ratios of Logan's videos. So why could this possibly be the case? Bots on YouTube certainly do exist, absolutely, but they don't have past libraries of actual content, real branded identities, and a legitimate human footprint online. So why are a bunch of real channels acting like bots on Logan's content while he himself simultaneously spams half of YouTube with wannabe friends comments beneath all the videos? During his investigation, Evans happened upon a possible explanation to all this, which has now been dialed up and proven further in the aftermath of his upload. It became clear that many channels were posting messages directly to Logan in various capacities, begging for their own channel access to be returned, saying that they had been hacked after engaging with his comments or subscribing to his channel. This is where things get even worse. The bot program Logan is utilizing has now been confirmed as being able to crawl private videos. YouTube is not just a content sharing platform, it can also be used and is used in a lot of circumstances for private video content hosting. You do not have to make something public on your channel when it is uploaded. You can store memories there in the private category or personal projects or any number of things, but private videos are intended to be visible only to the account holder. Logan's bot being able to see and comment on private videos is not a good thing. It is a breach of personal boundaries and should be looked into. But when you factor in the allegations of channel hacking, somehow simply from engaging with the spammed comments or subscribing to Logan's channel itself, it becomes a full-blown catastrophe if true. Now, simply replying to a comment on YouTube should obviously not be a gateway to an account becoming compromised. I don't know if I'm in full acceptance of this, since I cannot picture any possible way that just replying would allow a hacker enough access to circumvent two-factor authentication and breach a Google account. But in the aftermath of Evans releasing his video, in which he was very antagonistic towards Logan himself, while also interacting with Logan's content directly and his comments during the course of that research and that video in the footage, his account has now become hacked. The hacker breached two-factor authentication and is now in control of his channel while locking him out entirely. There are a whole bunch of unknowns here, a myriad of things that don't make any sense, but even allowing for those doubts, the circumstances around this Logan channel are unbelievably suspect. At the very least, he has created the most sophisticated bot on YouTube, which is capable of breaching user privacy and commenting on private videos. And at worst, he has somehow created an engagement hack, which allows him to brute force his way into the accounts of anyone who interacts with him, which is many thousands of channels across the entire platform, and then use their legitimate accounts as a bot farm to boost his own metrics. Now, Logan does produce actual content himself. I don't think it's good at all, but he actually makes videos. However, the growth pattern here is a dead giveaway that something is up. His first upload was basically a welcome to the channel post, which is basically the most useless content on YouTube unless it is a pinned video that introduces the channel to new visitors when they already have an established audience. Logan, somehow, making a short, virtually algorithmically invisible welcome to my channel, please sub to me video, garnered well over 100,000 views on it in a couple of days, by the way, and it's still climbing, as he seemingly pulls in accounts from all over the platform through widespread bot account spamming, possibly turning those who interact with that spam, or his channel, in some capacity, into more bots to exponentially build. This isn't the first time a comment spammer network or channel has been exposed. The name I mentioned earlier, Tom or Ten, or Tim, he changed the name frequently, all the time, and had many separate channels, but has now been completely nuked. It's hard to tell, but all these pages right now that I'm swapping between in the footage, they are separate channels that were part of Tom's network of comment spam. They have all been terminated, but before that happened, he reached nearly 500,000 subscribers on the main one, with hundreds of thousands more across the others. Tom is also not the only one. It's a wormhole with seemingly no end, which is honestly to be expected, I guess, when examining a platform at scale like YouTube, but if all is to be believed from Evan's research, hell, if even half of it is true, then, and more than half of it appears to be true, having been verified on Twitter and other social media now by separate creators and viewers, then Logan, the most recent instance of a comment bot spammer, has kicked it up a notch and started infiltrating viewer accounts, manipulating their behavior, breaching privacy barriers, and doing it all to grow his own authentic channel on the platform. Here's the problem though. All of these issues, the Logan comment spam, the hacking allegations, everything really, it's incredibly hard to investigate because much like Tim or Tem or Tom, any of his names, doesn't matter, changed all the time, the branding and channel identity slash links are changed constantly. Here's an example of what I'm talking about right now. If you search Logan on YouTube and filter by channels, you immediately see Logan as the second result. It's not the same logo as the one in Evan's video, but it's extremely similar. And the description reads as follows. Logan doesn't own this channel. It is owned by his stepdad. We have a paid commentator slash personality for this channel. Okay, fine. Odd, but fine. Except when clicking it, you are taken to a channel called Vaxi, who uploads trash-tier Fortnite clickbait with the comments off and a hidden subscriber count. That type of Fortnite content is just a scam to get you to use their creator code most of the time, and it's an entirely separate wormhole I could do multiple separate videos on because there's so many instances of it. But anyways, if you go back to the channel search and scroll down, you see another Logan with an identical logo, also extremely similar to the Logan in Evans' video that he referenced, and the description reads, Vaxi doesn't own this channel. It is owned by his dad. We have a paid commentator slash personality for this channel. Except this one, when you navigate there, is actually still Logan for the title with absolutely no public videos at all and a hidden subscriber count. At this point, I can't tell if these networks, because there are quite a few, another name that has been popping up in my research is Calls, though I've never personally seen his comments on my own videos, but at this point, I can't tell which ones are connected to each other, or if this is all the same work of just one individual slash group, or a bunch of separate operations being run in isolation from one another. The important part here is that if any of these allegations and assumptions of hacking slash compromised accounts as a function of simply replying to a comment or subscribing to a channel are accurate, and even if they aren't, because breaching the barrier of private versus public videos is already unacceptable, even if it's just a spam bot, then YouTube has a massive problem on their hands. It's not the first battle that they have done with hackers and thieves. There are still dozens of channels out there that were never regained after being hacked for a crypto scam. This was, you know, a number of months ago and I covered it then. And I'm sure that there are other examples as well across all of YouTube. But sadly, the apparent threat of losing your YouTube channel and account appears to be increasing over time rather than decreasing like it should be, on top of a now apparent vulnerability in two-factor authentication. It's clear that YouTube is working on the problems, albeit slowly, but it's also clear a lot of their action revolves around public exposure of topics that they obviously aren't outright looking for of their own accord. So the end goal here is to help contribute my voice to that end, and maybe spur a sliver of positive change on the platform to keep more users safe from whatever this network of spam is really doing, whether that be hacking channels or viewer accounts, viewing private content, or anything else they might be up to. That's it for today, though. If you want to support, there are links down below, including Evans and another gaming creator as well. But keep in mind, as of the making of this video, Evans claims his account is still compromised, so be careful interacting with posts or comments over on his channel, at least until he's back in full control. Other links as well, merch, Patreon, Twitter, etc., but I'll cut it there and stop rambling. As always, thank you all for watching, and have a nice night.